Let's check out the third one right now. We have done first and second. I hope you have your cheat sheets with you. You should have it in the print, or you should have made notes of it by now. So bought office for furniture, two account that is reflected here. You can assume cash, you can assume bank. Let's assume cash. This the second account is furniture. Furniture came in, hence debit what comes in, as it is a real account. Asset, cash went out, hence debit what comes in, credit what went out. You can use this cheat sheet right here, as I am doing, as cash is right here, furniture is right here in real account, and I have applied the rules of real account. Let's go and put some entry in. Tally, accounting vouchers, go to vouchers, as there is a payment, hence the date is already selected, payment from cash. And what did we pay for? Furniture, 3000. Purchased furniture, Rupees 3K. Okay, enter. And as you know, we had already. Let's check out the balance sheet now, it will explain you more. Okay. So right here you can see the current asset was ₹10,000 previously, but now as ₹3,000 is deducted, it is now 7,000. And fixed asset account, that is, was zero, as there was a 3,000 plus, hence it is 3,000, which makes a total of 10,000, and 10,000 is stable here, is not changed. Let's check out this furniture account, fixed asset account. It says right here furniture. Okay, it is automatically classified into fixed asset because we have used for furniture the group is fixed asset, for cash the group is, for bank and cash the group is current asset. It might look tough now, but as you keep on doing it, you'll get thorough, and it will be the most easiest way.